gonna have a party this morning, and this is born. So this Elevenses, sorry, I'm leaning over at a very awkward angle. You can see right down my lovely top, possibly. A strange New Year's Eve, yes, very much so, very strange. Morning, Kate. So yes, okay, let me gather my thoughts. So I was thinking, okay, so what am I gonna do for an Elevenses? You know, I could do a roundup, and so I've been posting the posters for the roundup. I thought, okay, well, that's all well and good, but I want to do something, you know, a little bit different, a little bit special. And at the same time, I was doing, we were making a highlights video for Curated Canapés and Cocktails, which will be out later on today. I'll put that on Instagram and Facebook later on today. And as we were making the canapés and cocktails video, and if you don't know what they are on my Instagram. Just go to IGTV and look on series, and you can call them all up. I was thinking, oh yeah, we could use some of the trailers, because we did some quite fun trailers with canapés and cocktails, and then we realised that that wouldn't work because the trailers were filmed in a different format and blah 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 blah, boring. So today we are going to this is the royal we. I and you are we because you're just going to laugh at me, I think. I'm going to recreate some of the trailers from Canapés and Cocktails, and I want you to guess what they are. What work of art I was talking about. So good luck if you didn't watch any Canapés and Cocktails, you could still guess. So with that, I think, what do we need if we're doing something about Canapés and Cocktails? We need to make a cocktail! I can't even say it, I can't even speak already. So wait a minute, because I am going to get some. Woo! Please play, come on. Come on, baby. It's all going wrong already. Technology. Ice. So I'm making a champagne cocktail, obviously. Let's play it again. It's going very well, isn't it? And I've got the, I don't even know if you can hear it. But I've also got the, everything's on a baby. So this is the dancer's doing. Ice baby. That's enough of that. Ice Ice Baby. If you watch the Curated Canapés and Cocktails, Ice Ice Baby, my favorite song. I don't know, I seem to drink it. Seem to sing it every time I was making a cocktail. I don't really know what the measurements are here, but this is a lemon gin fizz. Bit of sugar syrup, apparently. And mix that all together. How much sugar syrup will I do? Don't want it too sweet, do we? And a bit of gin. So, Curated Canapés and Cocktails, a lot of fun. Some funny trailers as well, as you will see. How much gin? I don't know. What's the measure jar I'll do? I am going to drink this, by the way. Just to give you a fair warning. Let's get that over there. So here we go. So this is what you've got to do. And this is where we get Ice Ice Baby. Ice Ice Baby. Ice Ice Baby. Happy New Year, everybody. You started yet? Okay, do you know what? Let's do the rest in a minute, because the first trailer, maybe not the first trailer I did, but this is the first one we're going to do today. So bear with me, there are costume changes in this as well. Do you know what it is? So, Zack the juggler. Look, I didn't even spill any cocktail. Okay, are you ready for this? Don't know whether I am, I'm on remote control. But this was the one of the first trailers that I did. Here we are. And see if you can guess. Remember that one. Hello everybody. Yeah, Steph, you've got it. Oh my god, Steph's on the ball. Did you even see it? I think you probably did. So this was from Dagar's Little Dancer. So there we go. Well, yeah, by the way, I'm not turning off comments today. So Dagar's Dancer, which is, so this is the trailer that I did. I've still got the original catalogue from the exhibition, which we see 1881. So this is the work that I'm talking about. So it's a sculpture. And Dagar, it was a departure for Dagar, and he said that the Little Dancer was going to be finished for an exhibition of 1880, an Impressionist exhibition of 1880, original catalogue. And it wasn't ready. It wasn't ready. So people went to this exhibition looking at and looked at an empty case because he said it was going to be ready. Empty case. And so no Dagar's Little Dancer, aged 14 years, that year. Then the next year, he entered it again for the Impressionist exhibition, and it was exhibited. So in 1881, it was exhibited, and everybody hated it. They hated it. They said, why is she so ugly? She's a threat to society. And it was completely reviled. And actually, he had made her facial features look particularly unattractive. He kind of equated her to a criminal, which wasn't very kind of him. But that was, in fact, Dagar's Little Dancer. And you might think, well, Dagar might wish to stick to drawing, but he did do a few sculptures and they are now, of course, masterpieces. That one's now in Washington. So sticking to drawing brings me to costume change, brings me to the next trailer that I did, which was for something completely different. And it involved me drawing a complete masterpiece. I look like I'm putting a lab coat on, but no, this is my artist's attire, obviously. Hair up, clearly, because that's what artists do. Okay, so now my masterpiece. In the trailer, I drew a self-portrait in 2 minutes. This time, we're going to do a self-portrait in 1 minute. Because why not? I think it's going to go well. I think it's going to go well. So we have got some, I've got a minute, I think, worth of music here with a bit of a countdown at the end. So I can't believe I'm doing this. Okay, off we go. Self-portrait. Oh my god, okay, now it is nearly a minute. Oh my god. Oh my God. That's all I can say. Oh, sorry, excuse me. 1 second. Hello? Hello? There's some news. Okay, oh my goodness, that's big news. That is big news. Okay, 1 second. 1 second. Bye. Newsflash. Lord, it's just come in and it's quite extraordinary, really, because it involves an unclaimed masterpiece. This is, well, it has been left in the studio. It is a painting or a drawing. It's something that resembles possibly a woman. We don't know who the artist is, but it seems to be a woman aged, I don't know, around about 70, perhaps 80. She may well have had a stroke by the looks of things. So we don't know who the artist might be, and we are urgently trying to find this artist, because obviously they will want to claim their masterpiece. Okay, so tell me two things to guess. Well, not to guess. So first of all, what was the one I was drawing? Anyone remember that? Okay, I'm gonna give you a clue. It got rubbed out. If you guess it, then I'll show you. It was by Robert Rauschenberg, and the trailer was for a Curated Canapés and Cocktails called Erased. And basically, I did my masterpiece and I erased it. And this was emulating something that happened in 1953. So Robert Rauschenberg was doing a series of white paintings, and he had the idea that actually what he could do was he could take a drawing and he could erase it. But he thought, okay, well, that's not really going to work with one of my drawings. So I need to find somebody else's drawing to erase. That was going to be more meaningful. And so he went to the best draftsman, the best artist that he could think of, a sort of friend of his. He was quite feared, a man called William de Kooning. And he asked him, he took him a bottle of Jack Daniels apparently, and asked him if he could have one of his works of art to erase. He was terrified. And de Kooning got it. And he said, yes, you can. And he gave him a drawing, but he chose really carefully, because he gave him one that he would be upset to that he would miss. And he gave him one that would be particularly difficult for Robert Rauschenberg to erase. So these are the images. So this isn't from the trailer, but this is from the Erased itself. So that was my original masterpiece. I might show you this one in a minute. And this was the Rauschenberg Erased de Kooning drawing. And at the bottom, you can't see it in this image, but there's a little plaque that says Erased William de Kooning drawing Robert Rauschenberg, and that little plaque was done by Jasper Johns. So in effect, it's a work of art by three people. So that was Erased. And then did anyone guess what the newsflash was? That was from the newsflash. And that was when I did a little collaboration with the fantastic and the beautiful and the gorgeous Lillian Milgram and the hugely talented Lillian Milgram. If you don't follow Lillian Milgram on Instagram, follow her. She's incredible in all sorts of ways. So she wrote a book called L'Origine, the world's most erotic masterpiece. And that newsflash was all about her masterpiece, about her book, about the masterpiece, The Origin of the World, which is quite some masterpiece. I will show it. If you've got little children in the room, then you might want to distract them for a second. This is most definitely going to be censored, this one. So this is the work of art, and it was by Courbet, Gustave Courbet, and it has quite an extraordinary story. And this is what Lillian's book is about. It's a novel, but it's factual novel. And so Courbet painted this in 1866 for Cahil Bey, who was an Egyptian diplomat. And then this painting has had quite a journey ever since. It was thought potentially that it could have been painted it was thought that potentially the model could have been Joanna Heffernan, who we met, do you remember when we did Whistler's White? So Joanna Heffernan was Whistler's girlfriend and then went off with Courbet for a while. But anyone that's seen the painting would probably know that it's not Joanna Heffernan because she was a redhead. So it's Constance Canyu, who was a ballet dancer, a ballerina, and was Cahil Bey's mistress at the time. So that's what that one was. Okay, no one quite guessed, but I think I should show you. I'll show you at the end. Because I've got one more to go. And that was, okay, do you remember this? Do you remember this? Remember this trailer? No music for this one. I enjoy doing this trailer. This was the trailer I liked doing most. Apart from the fact that halfway through, quite at the beginning actually, I realised that there was a really disgusting stain down one of the bits of wadding, which is from Mindful Chef. Thank you very much, Mindful Chef. Do you remember this? Why did I cover myself in what I was calling felt? Why did I do that? I often ask myself why I did that. Why did I do that and why did I do lard? Look, you can see. Lard, that's what that says. I'm gonna do it. This was the trailer for something. Nice. Do you remember this? I'm covered in lard and I can't remember. Joseph Boyce. Oh, I should have asked you to guess. My God, that's a bit remiss of me, isn't it? I've just covered myself in lard and haven't asked you to guess. So do you remember, this was from the Joseph Boyce, yes, well done. Joseph Boyce was an artist from the 20th century who set up this whole myth that he continued throughout his life. Nice use of Mindful Chef in theatre. Thank you very much, Emma. And he said that he had been shot down over the Crimea in 1944, Second World War, but was saved by nomadic Tatars, and he claimed that this tribe had saved him and they had wrapped him in felt and they had covered him in lard to keep him warm, and that is how he survived. And he perpetuated this myth for his entire life. I don't think any of it was true. Well, I think his plane came down because of bad weather, it wasn't shot down, and so on and so forth. He also said that if you consciously peel a potato, then that could be a work of art. So think about that while you're cooking your nice New Year's Eve dinners tonight, because you could be creating art, ladies and gentlemen. You could be creating art. What made it? So that was Boyce. And here is, oh dear, it's a story. And here is, this was me peeling a potato covered in lard and, looking particularly fetching. Oh my God. Face cream, anyone? Nice. I think I'm going to finish that cocktail and bloody drink it. So there we go. So those were, how many did I just do? 4. Of my favourite, oh, you're peeling veggies, there you go, create a work of art, study. Yeah, 4 of my favourite, 4 of my favourite trailers that couldn't be put into the video because they were the wrong format. Okay, so here we go. Oh, bloody hell. Look, glass survived. So this, topped up with a bit of fizz. Why not? Stuck in the fridge. Don't know how fizzy this is still gonna be. Oh, that'll do. So, happy New Year, everybody. Oh, that's really nice. Okay, so it should have a bit of lemon peel in it to finish it off, but gin, lemon juice, a bit of sugar syrup, and champagne. Cheers. I'm gonna have to go and get in the shower now. Or maybe I'll just go out. I might just go walking around the streets. I was really hoping that the postman wasn't going to knock. I did have a knock on the door just before we went live, and I had a tutu on and a funny furry gilet and a pair of slippers. And I thought, oh, geez. But luckily, it was one of those deliveries where they left it on the doorstep and ran away. So anyway, happy New Year. God knows what we're going to do next week, but I don't think I'm going to be covering myself in stalk. Here's to 2021, everybody. Thank you very, very much for joining me. Happy New Year.